Good day people, welcome back to my YouTube channel Elliott Wave Principle. I'm your host Shaheen. I have done some research on US crude oil and I have decided to share with you guys. I'm also starting a new service on my Patreon page, which is basically patreon.com/ Elliott Wave Green right over here. I'm already providing the gold and silver bi-weekly analysis, and now in addition to that I have added the US crude oil weekly analysis as well. And if the prices actually move in a different direction than thought, then I'll also try to include the mid-weekly analysis as well to give an explanation of what the updated analysis is. So the first analysis is going free. I'm not going to discuss gold and silver. If you guys intend to see gold and silver updated analysis, you guys can see that analysis on patreon.com/ Elliott Wave Green. And right now we'll actually start our analysis on US oil. So for US oil to be analyzed correctly, I had to go quite a bit in the history and I had to look at the analysis. So in my understanding of the chart that's in front of us, I believe that we have completed a W pattern, which is basically a cyclic level wave A, B, and then wave C. So this is a flat correction, you guys, actually a zigzag correction. Right from over here, we can actually see that B actually possibly is completed right over here. So wave A right over here, wave B right over here, and then we can clearly see a five wave structure right over here, giving an indication that W is completed right over here. Now, all know that, of course, this is futures charts in front of you, and that's why the prices actually went to negative. In fact, the prices hang around somewhere around 11-ish dollar, right over here, 11.40-ish dollar. On some of the charts, the price, the bottom that was made on last year was around 7.50, I think. So this green line is basically indicating the bottom that we saw in 2020. Do not consider the negative value that was a futures. And that's the reason that we have a negative value right over here. So on spot cash value was positive, it never went on actually into negative. Here we can see right now that we have completed a wave A. I'm considering this as wave B and I'm considering this as wave C, giving an indication that we actually saw an expanded flat right over here, A, B, and C right over here, which is more clearly visible on this chart right over here. Let me have a look on a weekly time frame. So here is more better. We can see that wave A right over here, wave B right over here, and then wave C. It looks to me now that we have completed wave C. We are going to discuss wave C in a bit, but let's have a look at Optima first. The important thing that's giving me hint that we probably have completed X, which is a expanded flat correction right over here. And if that is the actually end of the completion, then we are looking for the price of oil to drop significantly, and then we are looking for the prices to kind of go in this area. We are still have a lot of price movement, so I believe next few months are going to be very interesting, and I'm looking for bearish price action in US oil in next few months, and I'll discuss that in step by step. So first of all, we need to have a look at the range from this top to this bottom right over here. And if we are considering this W, then X should be actually finding some support on the previous range. And that's exactly what we are finding right now, that X is actually found some resistance here. The first A leg, which is wave A, has found resistance around 37.5%, or you can consider it 38% or the Fibonacci. You can, either of the percentage can be considered. So the point here is that we can see the resistance came and then we have seen the reversal. And then from this bottom, once again, if you look at it, then we have reached at the 50% of the previous range. So this is a very, very important indication. If some prices reach the 50%, it's actually very, very good indication that the upward trend is going to be very strong. And that's the bearish trend that we're looking for. Another thing that's giving us a hint that the upward trend could be really strong is because an expanded flat. So an expanded flat is occurring on a reverse side, giving an indication that the bearish price movement that actually started back in 2008 has yet not completed. So I'm considering it as W and X and Y. Since these are commodities, we are definitely not looking into traditional five-wave correction, five-wave, and basically another correction and a five-wave. So commodities work a little different because they tend to move side to side, and that's what exactly we are seeing right now. We have completed W and we have completed X. That's what it looked like. The reversal that we have seen is quite solid on a monthly time frame, giving us an indication that we are actually strongly looking for a bearish price movement. Another point I want to make right over here, which will be more clear on this particular chart right over here, is that if you look at it, then basically we have a previous top right over here, and then previous top right over here, basically a double top was formed. Prices came back and they found a support on the previous wave four, but they went on right over here, giving us an indication that this is going to be a stronger price movement. But as we can see, that the price beyond the double top was unable to be sustained, and then we have seen the reversal. This is the classic behavior that these prices have been strongly rejected, and we have seen the deeper price movement, giving us an indication there's a high probability of this leg being completed. I've also drawn on a parallel channel the channel is actually supporting the whole price movement. We have combined wave two and wave four to extend it to the top of right this one or over here. You can extend the top right over here on this wave, over here on the side one, or on the side one right over here. But I think this will be more reasonable. This captures more price within the wave C structure. So we can clearly see that the price have fallen off from the support, giving us indication that there's a probability that we have completed the top right over here, and right now we are looking forward downwards. So I hope that up to this point the structure is clear. Right now, if you look at the structure on a weekly time frame, we can clearly see that this is wave A, this is wave B, and then this is wave C. It's finding resistance on the 50% of the previous structure, giving us a clue this is 37.5% or 38%, and this is 50%. So this is giving us an clue that's stronger. We have probably found the end of this structure that was going right over here to right over here. Let's have a look on a daily time frame and see what's actually happening right now. Let me zoom into 4 hourly time frame. Actually, hourly will be much better. If you guys are looking to trade this on a small time frame, then we are also seeing some very good trading setups. And then we can see right over here that we have seen the prices to drop and a correction. And then we have seen the prices to drop and another correction. And then we have seen the prices to drop and another correction. This is wave A of our expanded flat. This is wave B of the expanded flat. And this is wave C of the expanded flat. So this is also providing the top of the previous one of the structures in the previous structure as well, on a smaller time frame, definitely, basically. So I'm right now considering this as wave A, and this as wave B, and then this as wave C. I have intentionally not labeled this from smaller 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 intentionally, because we are still not sure about the exact labeling. So we can still try to label it 1, 2. And then we can say that 3-4 is yet not complete. So we can have 1-2-3-4 and then 5. So I think that'll be much better. So we'll have 3-4 and 5 further down, okay? But let me bring that over here. And this is the inside labeling. We have not considered this wave 1 and this wave 2. That will be a higher degree wave 1 and a higher degree wave 2. And then this will be a higher degree wave 3, basically. But if you're looking at the possible structure, then that will definitely pretty hard to find the resistance for a price target. But for now, there's one indication, and that indication is that we have seen expanded flat, and the prices are have come up the support quite strongly, giving an indication that we can use $69.34 as a good stop loss level. Please use money management if you are actually trading on a smaller time frame. If you want to keep a little more careful, then definitely use this top right over here. But it's up to you how you want to trade this. So right now I'm considering this whole price movement as A and B and then C, definitely. So I hope that I was actually able to provide some help. I'll be sharing this
more and more on my Patreon page, and I would really love to. This is going to be minute. I would love to invite you guys to come on, join me on my Patreon. I have quite a good stuff available for gold and silver, and now we'll also be adding weekly US crude oil too. So the first analysis that I've posted is free one for my YouTube subscribers. I have already given a forecast of Bitcoin. If you have missed it, then go ahead and check it out. Bitcoin has already moved quite accordingly to our analysis, and you might get surprised what I have given on Bitcoin analysis, and will really help you if you're trading on a cryptocurrency. Wish you good luck with your trading. I hope that you liked the analysis. If you did, please push that thumbs up button and subscribe. Have a good one, and bye-bye.